twinkling toes is my daughter. Once a pale and sickly child, weak in the limbs and hardly able to walk, until she started to take Indian wizard oil. Shoulder my hitch kick, Sally.
Sort of bold, don't you think?
What do you say, Grandma?
I said she's sort of bold. Oh, mercy.
Hey, Scuttle, where do you think you're going?
Can I see the show, too? Or does the Cortlandt family own the whole square?
Never mind about the Cortlandt family. You just keep your horse's head off my lap.
You had a right to let me know you're coming in. I got to pull over.
Well, pull over now. Not an inch.
Hey, one short a time, folks. One short a time. And now you might ask, what brings a physician of my reputation away out here to Western Pennsylvania?
These Bezabers don't look like they was going to spend a dime.
Oh, they'll spend all right when Paul gets wound up. Paul can sell white pants to a coal miner.
At any cost, just the same, I'm going to see that each and every one of you can enjoy the benefits of this remarkable oil. I'm going to pass out sample bottles absolutely free. My daughter, my little daughter, will go among you like a ministering angel. Give it away, Sally. Give it away. From now on, folks, you got no cause to go around dragging one foot after the other. Laugh right back at life. Be as light on your feet as a young gazelle.
Thanks. So you know you're the best-looking ministering angel I see in a long time.
Hand one up here, young woman, long as it's free.
Thank you.
And now Chief Yellow Cloud will pass among you and collect a small sum of 25 cents. Not for the oil, mind you, merely to cover the cost of the bottle.
Keep good. Big Chief say so. Keep good.
Hey, just a moment, sir. This compound of yours is nothing but plain, ordinary rock oil. Why, this stuff comes from here, seeps right through our ground.
Young man, you don't know what you're talking about.
I know rock oil when I smell it.
You wouldn't know the side of a barn unless it hit you. Who told you you were smarter than the Indians?
It's got nothing to do with the Indians.
It's got nothing to do with the Indians? Did you ever see a white man turn a flip-flop at the age of 84?
You just saw Chief Yellow Cloud do it, didn't you, Smart Aleck?
And now I'm going to ask Chief Yellow Cloud to give me another exhibition of his strength. I'm going to ask him to take you by the nape of the neck and throw you off the square.
Don't hurt him, Peter.
Hurt him? Chief! Chief!
Chief!
Yellow Cloud!
Chief!
Chief!
Yellow Cloud!
Chief!
Sally!
Jeepers! Talk like an Indian, you fool!
Said it was good for anything.
You got some place to put your horse?
We ain't even got some place to put ourselves.
The girl could sleep on the sofa in the parlor, and the two men could lie up in the stable.
Well, this is a great kindness, madame.
But you'll have to leave right after breakfast. I ain't running a hotel.
We ain't asking for charity, Pop.
Oh, no.
Jump in. We'll take the girl in front.
With pleasure, with pleasure.
Pop, out of the... Oh, I could get in by myself if I wanted to.
You mean to say you're going to accept favors from a man who said your medicine was rock oil?
Shut up. It is rock oil.
Good morning. Who's this?
Peter's great-grandmother. I was married in that dress, too.
I wish I had my mother's wedding dress. My, you've got so many pretty things. I guess a house is a good thing to have, isn't it?
Don't you think it's time you was getting dressed?
Oh, is this late?
It's going on 7 o'clock. Morning's half over.
Oh, it's just like a picture book out there. Cows and sheep. Pretty white doves.
A farm's hard work from sun up to dark.
What's that thing? Looks like a window without sails.
Tain't nothing that sensible. It's something they call a derrick. And my grandson's out there fooling with it, and he ought to be clearing the North Meadow. He's digging way down in the ground for rock oil.
I thought he was a farmer.
He is, but he's got this crazy notion about oil now. Says he's gonna keep the poor man warm and light up every little shack in the country.
Die. The most beautiful woman in the world just kissed me.
She's been in and out of this hayloft all night.
There's your things. Oh, I ain't gonna look at you.
Thank you, Mrs. Cortlandt.
You better hurry up and get dressed now. I'm gonna give you and your father and that other fellow your breakfast, and then I'll have done my Christian duty. From then on, you must shift for yourselves.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello, Oscar.
Want your breakfast?
Yes. Treat, treat, treat. Dee-dum, da-da-da. High, wide, and handsome, I'm riding the line high. Run, little one. Wish to wear the bird, just so you could go. High, wide, and handsome, I'm riding wide and high. Run, little horsey, run. Wish you was a bird, just so you could fly.
Good for you. You pick up a tune quick.
Always did have a good ear.
You got a mighty pretty voice, too, Mrs. Cortlandt. Mighty pretty.
Are you trying to get around me? Because if you are, it won't do you mighty good. You could tell me I had a voice like an Italian prima donna. You'd still have to be out of this house within the hour.
Yes, ma'am.
What do you want me to do with this old back-breaking foot drill, Mr. Cortlandt?
Roll it down the hill. Dump her in the creek. Burn it.
Maybe you better wait till you find out if this fancy new engine works.
It'll work all right, as soon as we get it together.
Hey, Cortlandt. Got your pipes here. What'll I do with them?
Unload them.
Wait before I can see why you need all that pipe casing.
Gotta go far down.
How far are you now?
About 30 feet.
And you can skim all the rock oil you need right off the top of the creek.
Not all I want. Oh, I ain't trying to get all just for myself.
Well, who are you trying to get it for, Peter?
Maybe for people in Philadelphia.
Philadelphia?
Yeah, and Boston and Baltimore and Pekin and Constantinople.
Awful lot of people in them places. Suppose you'll have to be getting more help pretty soon, I reckon.
Yeah, that's what I figure. Stop it up, Davy! Get on that bow, will you, Lamb, and lower away.
All right, Peter.
Zeke!
Come in here and give me a hand.
Guide that drill. I bet they hit China before they hit oil. Watch that drill hole, Shorty. There's liable to be a bunch of little Chinese gals pop out of there any minute.
You put the other clamp in. All right, now go ahead. Go ahead. That's it.
Oh, What's the matter? Ah! What's the matter? Oh. That's it. Come on. Come on.
Steady. Steady. Oh. Steady, Lamp.
Hitch on your tools.
We're all set, Peter.
Hey, Gabby, get on that control.
All right, Peter.
Looks like it'll do all right. Be quicker than the old foot drill.
I don't like to bother you. I've got a message from your grandma. She says you got an old hay wagon maybe you don't need.
Yeah, I got an old broken wagon, that's so.
Well, I was thinking maybe if you don't need it, Pa could fix it up for us to use. You see, we ain't got a wagon or nothing now.
It'll take some time to make anything out of that old wagon, won't it?
A couple of weeks, Pa thinks. I could help your grandma in the kitchen. She says it's all right with her if we stay, so long as it's all right with you.
Yeah, it's all right with me.
Enjoyed your dancing last night, Miss Watterson. Wasn't surprised to hear the wagon catch fire. Almost busting the flames myself.
So you're kind of smart, ain't you?
I ain't as smart as Cortlandt there. You know what he's doing? He's digging up enough oil for all the people in the world.
Well, maybe that's a pretty good thing to do.
Well, I don't think all the people in the world has got rheumatiz or jaundice. Whatever your pop said the rock oil was good for, some of us don't need it.
Blockheads don't know what it's good for, maybe. Blockheads ain't figured out that maybe you can light lamps and make stoves go with rock oil.
That's good. Lighting all the lamps in Philadelphia and Pekin, China. With rock oil from Peter Cortland's farm. Ha ha!
Clear out of here, Red.
Yeah, I guess maybe I better. Before I start getting queer IDs myself. See you later, Miss Watterson. On the other side of the fence.
Who told you?
Tell me what?
About this, what I'm aiming at.
Oh, I just kind of figured it out for myself.
You've been talking to Grandma.
Maybe. Come to think about it, she did say something about you having a daffy notion in your head.
You think it's daffy?
Yes, I think it's daffy. Pretty daffy.
Oh. Looks like it might be a good idea for everybody to get back to work instead of wasting a lot of time over a lot of silly jabbering. And if you're going to earn your keep by helping Grandma, why don't you go and start in?
See, you can't talk bossy to me like that, Mr. Cortlandt. I ain't used to it.
And I ain't used to being told I'm daffy.
You ain't. Well, it's about time somebody told you.
Right snippy little piece, ain't she?
She's kind of snippy.
To fool a simple maiden whose heart with love was laden. To fool a simple maiden whose heart with love, alas, was laden.
Then she runs off the stage crying.
And is that the end?
No, he marries her at the end.
Oh. I like comic opera. I loved the one I saw. Land sakes, look at that sun. Red as a tomato and right on top of the hill. Peter hasn't fed the stock yet.
I'll feed him.
You think you can?
Of course I can.
All right. Now that's for the chickens and that's for the horse.
Right. You just throw it to them, don't you?
That's all.
Hello, chickens. I'm bringing you your dinner today. What's the matter? Well, what are you running away for?
Mercy me! I said throw it to them, not at them.
Why did you come to the well every morning? If not to laugh at me. Oh, no, Susetta, I would not laugh at you. Oh, the love you need, I left to see her.
with his bills. I reckon you don't know much about pigs.
No, but I'm learning.
Well.
Hi, White and Handsome.
How you coming along, Pop?
Oh, we'll ever finish on time.
Don't work too hard.
I'll bet Sally will be glad to get away from here.
Do you think so, Mac?
Sure. She's always fighting with that Cortlandt fella. She hates the sight of him.
You know human nature, don't you, Mac?
From A to Z.
You must have skipped W. Women come under W.
Well, why'd you come up this side today?
I went by the barn to see how Pop was getting along.
You're late this morning.
Well, Peter, I'm a half hour earlier than usual.
Oh, seem like you're awful late.
Well, here's your vinegar sling.
Thanks. Ah. Mmm. Good. You going Friday?
Yes. Pop says the wagon will be ready by then. Oh, I love it up here on this hill.
Just the same, I bet you're hankering to get back on the road.
Oh, I don't know. It's been kind of fun living in a house and cooking in a real kitchen. I surely will miss your grandma. Oh, I've got to get back, too. She'll be mad and I'll get out if
I... Oh, don't go yet. I want to ask you something. It's about Thursday night. They're having a kind of jamboree over at Doc Lippincott's and...
Oh, yes, your grandma told me.
I was thinking, I don't know, it might not be very exciting for you, but I was wondering whether...
You want me to go to the dance with you?
Yeah, that's what I'd like.
Well, I'd love to go, Peter.
Will you?
Of course I will. Well, I got to get back to work now. The picture, please.
Now, listen at those birds sing. They don't usually sing this time of day.
Don't they?
No.
Oh, goodbye.
First couple out to the right and swing. All other couples keep walking in a ring. Balancing and all eight swing. Left hand man and a right hand grand. See how you did all that work in one day.
Oh, it took us 4 days.
But I didn't ask you till yesterday.
I'm sorry to see that the tone of this here gathering ain't as high as we like to keep it in our sociables around here.
Oh, you mean Red Scanlon? Well, as long as he behaves himself.
No, I'm referring to that medicine show gal your grandson brought here, Mrs. Cortlandt.
By the way, Mr. Stark, what do you hear from that brother of yours at the penitentiary? His term for horse stealing's about up by now, ain't it?
Everybody up for the kissing game! Where's the...
James's son, and of that royal race he sprung. He wore a star upon his breast to show that he was royal best. He wore a star upon his breast to show that he was best.
Go choose your east, go choose your west, go choose the one that you like best. It is not here to take your heart, go choose another.
Go choose another, go choose another with all your.
Farrello, what's a fuss about? She's been kissed before, ain't she? Wasn't she with a medicine show? Looks like we're gonna have some fun. Finish this fight fair.
Well, that's what I want to do.
Take him to the house and hold him there till Peter goes.
You ought to send the girl away, too.
Easy, Rad. We ain't throwing this yet, Cortland. Remember that. I don't leave no fights unfinished.
All right. Oh, come on, Rad.
We have to ask you to leave, Peter. Let him go, boys. And come over and apologize to Mrs. Lippincott tomorrow, Peter. That was a good one you gave him.
This is a shortcut home.
Oh, it's beautiful here.
Yep. Apples.
I got kind of scared when you were fighting. I thought he was hurting you.
Thanks for getting scared.
Oh, I love it here.
Can we sit here and talk a while?
Uh-huh. Mmm. The air smells so sweet.
I think you're sweet.
Go on. We'll get to the sea, maybe.
Are you going tomorrow for sure?
Uh-huh.
It's been nice having you here. Your pa always cracking jokes and you singing songs and everything.
Oh, we like being here.
Well, I guess you'll be glad to get back on the road. First thing you know, you'll forget all about us.
Maybe. Think you'll forget about us?
Maybe. In a couple of years.
Shut your eyes and feel the moonlight. It's like you were drowning in silver.
Can I forget you? Or will my heart remind me that once we walked in a moonlit dream? Can I
take this.
It ain't heavy.
You know what we said about forgetting in a couple of years? Well, I don't think I'll ever forget you.
It's been a mighty pleasant little visit, Mrs. Cortlandt.
Well,
a mighty pleasant
little
visit.
Best we could to make you comfortable.
Goodbye, Grandma Cortlandt.
Goodbye, Charles. Thanks for the dresses and for everything.
Come on, Sally. Right. Goodbye, Mrs. Cortlandt. I hope to repay you handsomely.
Never
for
mind
all you've
about
done.
Paying me. You just look after your daughter.
Off you go, Mrs.
Cortlandt.
Goodbye.
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 There was something I wanted to tell her.
Then why didn't you? Why don't you? Go on!
Wake up!
What's up?
Waste out a mite. She ain't as delicate as I was.
Yes, 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 that's pretty good. But now, would you please look over at me? I like that much better. That's it. Now, will the bride take the groom's arm? Oh, lovely. Now, don't be nervous, children. Take it easy. Just a moment. Won't take long. Let me see. Over here. Yes, yes, yes. That's pretty good. Now, just let me see from here. No, I don't like that. Oh, there it is. That, I like that much better. Yes, that's the one. Smile as though you were happy. Lovely. Now, don't move. Steady. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 115. That's it!
Will you marry me tomorrow, Mariah? Will you marry me tomorrow, Mariah? Your ma thinks I'm unsightly, your pa insults me nightly, but tell them both politely to jump in the lake.
I'll have no dilly-dallying, Mariah. I'll have no shilly-shallying, Mariah. Don't wait until tomorrow,
but get dressed up in your bombazine and go to the church in the village green.
Mariah, I can't wait to marry you.
Will you make my apple brandy? Will you take my socks to darn?
Don't forget that you're a handy man around the barn.
I'll have no dilly-dallying, Mariah.
Show you something.
We shouldn't go off like this.
Why don't you start arguing with me right off the bat? Come on.
I'm all out of breath.
Good, then I can do all the talking. You want to know what I brought you up to show you?
Yes, what?
It's going to be right here.
What's going to be right here?
The house I'm building for you.
Peter!
It can be painted white. If you like white houses, I hope you do.
Oh, I love white houses. And I love you for wanting to build it for me up here on our hill. But, darling, you've got a house.
Oh, Grandma'll stay in that one. She says a young couple ought to be alone. Come on, sit down. I'll tell you about it. I was up here this morning staking the whole thing out.
Where's the front porch going to be?
Oh, it's going to be a beauty. Runs across here, 30 feet, and facing south.
Oh, Peter.
Good luck. Everything's going to be different from what we figured.
Peter, look. look what you've done.
Oh, never mind that. You can have anything you want now.
But I got everything I wanted. Right here.
Look at it.
This oil business very definitely concerns us. It concerns us here in Philadelphia. It concerns our Wall Street friends in New York, our other associates in Cleveland and St. Louis. In fact, clear out to San Francisco. They all agree this may be one of the big industries of the future. So, I think it's high time we went to Western Pennsylvania and took control of it.
Getting control of an industry, Mr. Brennan, takes time and a lot of money.
Certainly does.
Yes. That is, unless someone thinks of a shortcut.
Meaning?
Well, these oil fields are owned by a group of hard-headed farmers. They won't sell out. But their oil's no good unless it's refined. They can't get it to the refineries unless they use our railroads. So, if we keep raising the freight rates, we lower their profits to a vanishing point. Well, you gentlemen have certainly heard of a little game called freeze out.
Oh.
Yes.
Good morning.
Good morning. Same thing every day. Paying a lot of men to come up here and do nothing.
We can't start building your house less than we know front from back. We just got started working with Mr. Cortlandt, and then he had to go. Said it was something awful important.
My husband's a very busy man these days. I guess you better tell your men to go on home.
Guess that's all we can do, Miss Cortlandt. I'm sorry. Come on, boy.
Hey, Lem. Lem!
Huh?
Have you sorted all that correspondence on the railroad rates?
Yes, here it is.
And I want everything else from the Brennan offices in Philadelphia.
Oh, you ain't human, Peter. Look at that clock. The roosters will be crowing soon.
Never mind. Now get me what I'm asking for. Then you can go home. I gotta have my facts dead straight before I tackle Mr. Walt Brennan and company.
And that's the worst of the evils these strangers have brought with them. The shanty boat. It's time the God-fearing people of this county took action. These gamblers and women and whiskey sellers have got to be driven off the creek. Get out.
There, that's for yourself.
Thank you, honey.
So this is the sporting life in Titusville.
What a world this would be if I made my wishes come true. But the world offers me only long shot chances and vague romances to see.
There's the fellow I was telling you about, Peter Cortlandt, the one who's been making all the trouble.
And to learn they never come true.
Brennan. My name's Cortlandt. We had an appointment.
Sure. Sit down, Cortlandt.
Mr. Brennan, we got to have an understanding about...
Wait until the little lady finishes her song.
The things I get are what I never seem to want. The things I want are what I never seem to get. I'm just a discontented dreamer with a discontented heart. I'm just a gambler who can never win a bet. The kind of man I seem to find is one with fun upon his mind and not much time to spare. And then I find another kind who wants to put me on a pedestal because I'm fair. And then he leaves me there for someone else who's fair. The things I get are what I never seem to want. The things I want are what I never hope to see. And so it isn't any wonder now that I'm in love with you that I'm afraid to ask if you're in love.
Let's have another chorus.
Look, Brennan, I didn't come here to listen to singing.
Shh.
I'm talking for a group of men who ship 4,000 barrels of oil a day on one of your railroads.
4,000 barrels, huh? My, my, my. Think of that. How this business is growing.
Growing fast enough to be interested in the big business, men.
Yes, Mr. Cortlandt. Well, I think it's time men with some important capital came in and organized it.
What about the men who started it? Put their savings in it, put their hearts in it, and built it up to what it is.
I admire them. What courage. What adventure. Have another drink, gentlemen?
Thank you.
Yes, sir,
Mr. Cortlandt. You can well feel proud of yourselves. Why, do you know that you're giving your country a new industry?
You like it, do you? You like it so well, you want to add it to your collection.
You've got things a little mixed up. I'm only interested in railroads.
Yeah, I heard you were. You're the one who's raising freight rates so high, we'll have to shut down our wells.
Why not raise the price of oil?
Because our life and the life of our industry depends on putting out refined oil cheap, so as the poor man can buy it.
The poor man. Oh, I see. Well, Cortlandt, what's your solution to it all?
Lower your rates.
Let me fill your glass.
Never mind that. You listen to me, Brennan. Your rates have got to be lowered.
Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Cortlandt, but you must permit me to run my own business.
That's final, is it? I'm to go back and tell them you refuse to change the rates.
No, no. Don't tell them that. I'm going to change them. I'm going to raise them again tomorrow.
Oh, Sally, that cake's a beauty.
It don't look so bad for a first cake, does it?
Why, no.
You'd think he'll like my dress, Grandma.
Well, it's ruffled, ain't it? All you have to do to catch a man's eye is tack on a ruffle somewhere.
Now, when he comes in, I'll be singing and playing, and you have the candles all lit. You think he'll like the cake?
Why, of course he will.
He can't do that. Does Mr. Brennan own the world? He thinks he does, him and all his friends in Philadelphia. They think the United States of America is just a big pie for him to cut up and pass around among themselves.
Ain't a time somebody stopped him? Ain't a time somebody stood up to him?
We've got to stop him!
I'm glad to hear you feel that way. I know for myself I expect to be fighting Brennan and people like him to the end. And I'm glad I don't have to fight him alone.
Sorry, honey.
Something extra special came up tonight, and I couldn't get away.
Oh, I waited and waited. I must have dropped off to sleep. Peter, dear. Seems there's always something extra special lately.
I know, honey. I feel terrible about it, being away so much, and especially tonight, you baking that nice cake and everything.
It don't look so good as it did.
I bet it tastes good. Can we have some now?
Of course you can. I'll light the candles all over again, and we'll open the presents and have a real party. Oh, you poor thing. But you're so tired you can hardly see. Well, we should give those railroad men a good licking and send them about their business. Then maybe we could settle down to living. Maybe we could get started on the house. I was up on the hill today. My, it was beautiful. I don't suppose there's a spot in the whole world where I'd rather build a house. Can we start it soon, Peter? Peter.
And evildoers, get off this rotten raft and take your women with you.
Get ashore!
Over the county line, and don't you never set foot back in this land of decent people.
Get away!
Let them off.
Stop, please! Stop. Leave me alone! Get away!
Get that woman!
Leave me alone! Leave me alone!
Burn! Burn them! Get out! Take that witch out!
Come on, get a move on.
You can't do that. This girl can't walk.
Make that Jezebel walk. Drag her by the hair. Drag her by the heel.
Come on, go on. Get along. William City, over the line.
Peter, come on, take her inside.
You can't take her into your house. A wench off a shanty boat.
Who's telling us who we can take into our house? The girl's hurt. She's nearly dead. She's going to be taken in here and nursed until she's well again. If it ain't too late.
She's got to go across the county line tonight.
You ain't the law. Nobody made you judge of right and wrong. Nobody but yourself. Bring her in, Peter.
I reckon you don't know what you're doing, Peter Cortlandt.
Get your men off of my property, Stark. And get them off quick.
You're taking this on yourself. Remember that. I'm holding you responsible to every church-going citizen of the county.
Put her on the sofa, honey. And run upstairs and get those two heavy green blankets in the hall closet. Mercy! Who is she? Where'd she come from?
She's off a shanty boat.
A shanty boat, woman? In my parlor? She's hurt and she's soaked through to the skin. Guess I better heat some water. High, wide, and handsome, a yeller moon above. Why, I'm riding high, 'cause I'm riding to my love. Oh. And this is the hat that went with it, see?
Oh, it's awful pretty.
Do you ever miss all that excitement? Ain't you ever a little homesick?
Oh, I got a home. I got a husband to think about.
About all you can do is think about him. You don't see him very much. The whole 2 weeks I've been here, he's been out every day from morning till night.
Well, he's having business troubles. He's fighting the railroad.
That Mr. Stark. He's been bothering him too, ain't he?
What do you know about
that? Oh, I heard all the fuss yesterday. The door was open. The elders of the church and all coming up and telling you to throw me out.
Well, don't you worry. You ain't leaving this house till I say you're strong enough to go.
That won't be long. Oh, Sally, you've been so wonderful to me. I'll never forget
it. Stop talking rubbish. Here, open your mouth. I've been thinking about getting a job for you. There's a carnival show coming along this route pretty soon. I know the man that runs it. Pop Bars. He's a friend of Pa's.
But I'd be no good with a carnival show. All I can do is sing sad songs and make people cry after they've had a few drinks.
But you could learn something lively. I could teach it to you. That's my line. No Allegheny Al? Who's that rascal there? Who's that steamboat dandy? Allegheny Al, Allegheny Al. Bear grease on his hair makes him shine like candy. Allegheny Al.
Is that her? Is that the woman off the shanty boat?
No, it sounds like Sally's voice.
You mean that's your daughter-in-law up there singing and dancing to that woman?
Well?
Mercy, I'm late. I promised Miss Henderson I'd drop in on her this morning. Bye, Wilhelmina. Bye, Miss Ramage.
Bye. Penelope, be sure and tell Mrs. Henderson and all the rest of the gossips about the terrible scandal. Tell them the Cortlandts are practically running a shantyboat on land.
Wilhelmina.
And the next time I see any of them, I'll tell them about something I know that happened on a certain hayride. That time we all went up to Hydetown. Because before you met your husband, you was carrying on with Alf Cotton.
The photographer? Well, that was more than 30 years ago.
It'd still make a spicy story.
Oh.
We seem to be hurting ourselves more than we're hurting the railroads.
We are.
You think so? You go take a look at the empty cars off on the railroad sidings and figure out what the other side's losing.
Beamer here says they've got so much money they can hold out from now till doomsday.
That's right.
Now look here, man. Just because a couple of...
Mr. Cortland, a porter just come from the market house. Says Mr. Brennan wants to see you right away.
You hear that? Maybe Brennan's a little tired of fighting, too. Maybe he don't like his cars being empty any more than we like our pumps being idle.
Go over and see him now, Peter.
We wait for you here.
All right, you wait here. I got an idea. I'll bring back some good news.
Now, just between you and me, why don't you give your business to the central refineries in Pittsburgh?
Your railroad owns that, don't it?
Exactly. You deal with our refinery, and there'll be certain favors that you'll get to make up for the high freight rates.
Oh. Then the rates wouldn't be hurting me. They'd just be freezing out the rest of the fellas.
Say, you catch on quick. You've got a good head for business.
Well, it ain't hard to figure out. All it amounts to is plain everyday stealing. A few men stealing what belongs to a lot of men.
That happens to be a pretty good definition of business. We can't change it, so why try? Sooner or later, oil's got to be controlled by a small group of strong men. Well, might as well be us.
Who do you think this oil belongs to by rights?
Ones who grab it first.
It belongs to the world. It's for everybody to benefit by. You can't tie it up and make it any price you like.
Oh, but I can, and I will.
Not while I've got any breath left in my body to fight you.
Fight me? Don't be a fool. What could you do without the railroads? How would you get your oil to the refineries? Carry it in your hat or roll it there? I don't know who you think you're bluffing, but I do know you can't live without the railroads. Fight me, huh? Well, go ahead and fight.
I will.
the matter?
Something wonderful.
Did Brennan give in?
Come here.
What do you see?
Bad weather.
No. That pipe. See that rain pipe?
Yes.
See the water flowing through that pipe?
Yes.
Well, it isn't water. It's oil. It's oil flowing through a pipe.
Peter, have you been drinking? Here, sit down.
You think I'm out of my head, John? Well, I am. I am from plain excitement. I got pipes on the brain. Iron pipes. Miles and miles of them. Carrying our oil. Clear across the state, right smack into the refineries.
You mean?
I mean we'll tell the railroads to go to blazes. And give Brennan a great big laugh right in his face.
Gee, Hossifat, Peter. You have thought of something.
Now, Mr. Engineer, come on, get busy. Get busy.
Wait a minute.
What's the matter?
What about the cost? Have you thought of that? Not to mention the price of the pipe itself. Iron isn't butter, you know.
I know that, John. You begin to draw this pipe on paper, I'll do the rest.
Peter, you realize that this thing is going to take every penny you farmers have got. Maybe more. Can you afford to take that gamble?
John, we can't afford not to. Get busy, man. Get busy.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait
Come on.
I have to have my map.
Map?
You slammed that front door? What is that you're bringing up here?
Stars.
What's the matter with you, Peter?
Oh, I ain't myself tonight, Grandma. I'm King Solomon, wisest of men. I'm Alexander the Great.
Peter!
Shh.
Peter, oh, stop it. You're soaked. Where have you been?
Away from you. But I'm back. See? Back where I want to be all my days. Here's the brightest light I ever saw. Here's the sweetest thing in the world.
Oh, honey, you've had good news. Things are going your way. Something's happened. Something wonderful.
Something wonderful happened the day you was born.
Peter, stop. Where'd you get the apple blossoms?
Oh, they just busted out on me. I was a-hurrying home to you, and I just busted into bloom.
Peter, tell me, what has happened?
Don't bother me. Just be quiet. Just stay like this for a month of Sundays till Judgment Day. Like this with me. Close, honey. Close.
When you can laugh and be gay, everything's right for me. Everything's all right again.
Everything's going to be right from now on.
That's easy. You just look at me the way you're doing.
Mr. Cortlandt! Mr. Cortlandt!
Who's that?
I'm from Mr. Thompson's office. He's got to see you.
Tell John he'll have to wait till tomorrow.
He says he'll lose a whole day unless you come to see him tonight. He's got things to ask you. Says it's important.
Oh. All right.
Why does John Thompson have to ask you questions at this hour?
It's about what's happened. We thought of a way to beat Brennan. John and me figured out something. A way to carry the... I can't help it, honey. I gotta go. There's other men in this thing, and every day we save means something. Goodbye, honey. You get some sleep.
Seems like throwing good money after bad, Mr. Cortland.
But I wish you luck.
Thank you.
That closes out your account, Mr. Stackpole.
Yes, I know.
I'll have all mine.
Not bad.
Thank you.
They said they were going to lay pipe all the way to their refineries, and I'm darned if they haven't started it.
That's not funny.
Nothing to laugh at, Mr. Brennan. Suppose they finish it.
Oh, but they won't, Mr. Marvel. I'll show you something. This line is the pipe.
Mm-hmm. Well, why is it broken here?
Well, that gentleman is where Mr. Cortlandt and his farmer friends might get into difficulty. Funny if someone bought that entire strip, wouldn't it?
Yes, indeed. Oh, yeah.
You mean to say Brennan's bought every section in that 20-mile strip?
All except this one piece, 18.
Who owns that?
Joe Varez.
The Greek over at Petroleum City?
The fellow who runs the Hunky Dory.
He wouldn't sell to Brennan. Says he won't sell to anybody.
He's as smart as they make him. I wonder what he's after.
Let's go over and find out. We gotta have that. Jim Lamb, come along with What do you want for your land?
It's like this. Mr. Brennan say whatever you offer, he pay more.
Put you in a nice position, don't it, Joe?
Yeah. Elegant. You both got to have it, so somebody's got to give Joe anything he ask.
Well?
Well? Joe is a gambler, willing to give up cash from Brennan if you give good gambling chance. You got a fine oil land, Mr. Cortlandt.
You want my oil wells?
You got a fine land where you never put the wells.
He means your hill.
Yeah. I hear that's a fine property for prospecting. So I take that in trade for my land. You think Joe's smart?
You can't have that hill.
Oh. Too bad. Too bad for a pipeline. Too bad for you farmers lose all you got.
Look, Joe, that hill means something special to me. I've promised my wife we'd build our home there.
Oh, you got a wife. Well, I know how you feel. I had a wife once. She was a wonderful woman.
You better ask for something else, Joe.
Don't bother Joe no more. Don't like the bargains. Just to make it a yes or no. Nothing in between, please.
Got us, Peter.
Oh, he can't do that to me. It's crazy.
Well, he's got the only thing that can save us. We don't get his land, we have no pipeline.
That's right, Peter. Well, I could offer him a couple of wells.
He won't take that.
No, he's too smart for that.
You see, he's an old friend of mine. It's very important I find him.
Well, it won't do you no good to see Mr. Bowers now. We'll be all moved and packing in 10 minutes.
But where is he?
Well, he's over having a drink at that honky-dory place. Right over there.
Oh, thank you. Come on, Mike.
Come on, Patricia.
This is an awful place for you to come.
Don't you worry about me. I'm going to get you this job. There's Pop Bowers. Pop! Pop Bowers!
Sally! I'm so glad to see you. I see your father a few days ago. He's going to join my show in a couple of weeks, you know.
Yes, I know.
He tells me you're married and happy. Say, what are you doing in a place like this?
I'm looking for you. I was owed your pitch and they told me I'd find you here.
Well, it's lucky you found me. We were just getting ready to leave town.
Pop, this is Molly Fuller.
How do you do?
I'm awful anxious to get a job for Molly.
We haven't got what you call an opening with the show.
Oh,
Well, she'd take anything. She sings awful pretty.
Let's hear you.
You mean here?
Sure. Nothing like singing in front of an audience. Hey, George. Play something for this lady.
He don't like me.
Sure he does. Can you play Al again, Al?
Sure.
Good, he can play it, honey. Go on now, give it to him.
Seem both round the bend, round the river bend.
Sing louder, I can't hear you.
Make a little brighter, Molly. Play it a little faster, will you? Da, 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 that's it.
Steamboat round the bend, round the river bend, brings a scandalous gambling man with lots of money to spend. He's a howling swell, raring, tearing swell, highfalutin and hard to please, and rough on women as well. Who's that rascal there? Who's that steamboat dandy? Allegheny Al, Allegheny Al. Bear grease on his hair makes him shine like candy. Allegheny Al, Allegheny Al.
Back.
With a white diamond a blinking on his throat, and a sunflower, sunflower a stinking up his coat. As a quick kisser, a slick kisser, he gets the ladies' vote. Don't you let your gal meet that steamboat dandy, Allegheny Al, Allegheny Al.
Ain't she great, Pop? Play it through again, will ya? We'll show 'em. We'll make everybody sing. Come on.
Who's that rascal there? Who's that steamboat dandy?
Allegheny Al! Allegheny Al!
Sure. Bear grease on his hair makes him shine like candy.
Allegheny Al!
I think you decide very sensible, Mr. Cortlandt. I got a contract here.
Contract? How could you draw up a contract before we even decided that we were going to...
Ah, John, you. Mr. Cortlandt must say yes. No other way.
Who's singing out there?
Just to some girl.
Meet the steamboat dandy, Allegheny Al.
I came here with Molly, Peter. We...
Come inside.
His wife?
Yeah.
That her husband?
Yes, and it's all my fault, too. Mr. Bowers, you're gonna give me that job?
No.
Oh, I know I'm in the wrong, honey. I got kind of carried away trying to egg Molly on.
Carried away? Is that what you like, being stared at by a lot of gamblers and drunks?
Well, I want to see Molly get a decent job.
Molly? What do I care about her? Who's Molly? You are my wife.
Well, I didn't...
Standing on a table dancing in a cheap barroom. You can't do things like that. You ain't on a medicine show anymore. Maybe you'd like to be back doing that, running wild over the country with everybody gawking at you. Maybe you like that better than being a married woman.
Maybe I do. Come to think about it, I was enjoying myself. It's the best fun I've had in a long time.
Fun?
More fun than sitting home doing nothing. I'm not good at that. I want to be useful to somebody, even if it's only to a lot of strangers, singing them a song, telling them a joke, cheering people up a little. There's some excitement in that anyway.
If that life's so exciting, why did you marry me?
Because I thought you were the most exciting thing in the world. I thought we'd have the most exciting life of any two people.
Excuse me, please, Mr. Cortlandt. Mr. Cortlandt, if you sign up the contract right now, we can get transfer of deed before everything close up. Pen and ink over here, please. Oof, just a short letter. Just to say you give Joe the hill and he give you the land.
What hill is he talking about? It isn't anything about our hill, is it?
I got to let it go, Sally.
Let it go? Our hill? Oh, no, Peter, no, you can't do that.
There ain't no other way. I already gave my word.
But our house, Peter... It's already started.
There are other people to think of, honey. We've got to have that pipeline.
pipeline, oil wells. You've thrown away everything for them. All right. If it don't mean anything to you, it don't mean anything to me, then. Nothing does. Nothing matters. Nothing in the whole world.
You better come across the street, attend the transfer. She'll feel much better when we come back. You understand women. I figure them up just like that.
Fire your gun to signal us.
Oh! Who goes there?
Hold on, who's that?
Is it you, Peter?
What are you doing with that gun?
Well, Joe Williams was on guard, and he got took with a chill, so I'm taking his place.
Grandma, next time ask who goes there.
I did.
Yes, but you shot first and then asked.
It should be the other way around, Mrs. Cortlandt.
Oh, all right. All right.
Grandma, I'll have somebody come and take your place.
Good week's work, Scanlon.
Thanks, General.
Tonight, I want to hit them where it counts. Do you know the junction where all the pipes go into one big one?
Down by the bridge.
Yeah, well, if that were busted, it wouldn't be so easy to put together, would it?
Ain't gonna be so easy to bust. That's a heavy pipe.
I think maybe I can help you with this one.
How?
Who's that?
It's only me, Peter. Why don't you go to bed?
I don't sleep so well when I do go to bed.
I could think 'twas your grandpa sitting there. The two stubbornest men I ever knew. You just won't do the thing you're dying to do. Nothing could persuade you to go and get that girl back. Mrs. Dr. Lippincott come back from Harrisburg today, and she had news of Sally.
Well?
Seems there's a show in Harrisburg called Bowers Carnival, and Sally's singing in it.
Well?
Well, the whole town's talking about her. Say she's getting to be the most popular singer east and west of the Alleghenies. Why, a man told Mrs. Lippincott...
All right, Grandma, I'm going to bed now.
Going to bed? You better go and get her before she finds out she can get along without you.
Good night, Grandma.
Good night. Good night, boy.
Well, gentlemen, suppose we drink to our new agreement, and may we all prosper. Well, why don't you drink your champagne, Mr. Lippincott?
I don't feel altogether right. We promised Peter to see the governor and...
Oh, I wouldn't worry about Peter Cortlandt. You've stuck with him long enough.
And what have we got?
Nothing.
What side do you want to play on, the smart side or the dumb side?
Well, I know what you mean. And I've got my family to think of and...
Oh, now, Mr. Lippincott, you're talking sense. Molly, fill Mr. Lippincott's glass.
But Mr. Brennan, what's going to happen to the others? The ones who don't come over to your Pittsburgh refinery?
They'll be out. Out in the cold.
What about Peter Cortlandt?
Peter Cortland's got to be smashed. As a matter of fact, he's going to be smashed.
Perhaps you ought to explain that to the gentleman, Mr. Brennan.
Well, he's got to get his pipe to the refinery within a time limit. That's the contract, isn't it?
But the refinery's granted him an extension.
Ah, but suppose their bank doesn't consent to that extension. Suppose, for instance, that I'd bought that bank.
Exactly.
Well, that would leave him 2 days to complete 3 miles of pipe. That would be quite a trick to do, wouldn't it?
It certainly would.
Quite a trick to do.
Thank you.
Mr. Barnum.
That's him, all right.
To make up my mind about real challenge.
Thank you, Mr. Barnum.
And once I've made up my mind, it doesn't take me long to act on it. You're coming with me tonight.
Tonight?
Sure.
Where?
Over to the big show, New York.
But I'm with this show. We're going to Petroleum City tonight.
That'll all be arranged.
I wouldn't stand in your way, Sally.
I'll pay him well for your contract. Now, you've got 5 minutes to get dressed and start for the train.
Go ahead.
I'll have a hack at the entrance. Go get your clothes on. Scoot.
Hurry up, Sal.
Sally,
Molly.
Darling.
Oh, it's good to see you.
Sally, I've got some news for you.
What news, Molly?
Your husband, he's in trouble.
Peter? In trouble?
Your daughter isn't much of a quick change artist, is she?
Well, I'll see what's keeping her. Well.
You, Mr. Bonham?
Of course I am.
I got a message for you. She ain't coming.
Who ain't coming?
Sally, Miss Watterson. She had to go somewhere else.
What are you talking about, young woman?
She's driving to Titusville.
By herself? Why, that takes all night. Titusville? Why in blazes is she going to Titusville? Is the girl crazy, throwing away a future like I just offered her? Can anybody give her a future in Titusville?
Maybe somebody can. Maybe somebody.
All right, hold her up.
All right.
Peter. Colonel Blake from the Independent Refinery.
Wonder what he wants.
Afternoon, Colonel.
How are you, Peter?
What do you think of the time we're making? I tell you, in 1 week we'll
Peter,
have...
bad news. You haven't got a week. You've only got until tomorrow.
But, Colonel, you know it ain't humanly possible to finish by tomorrow. Why, it's 3 miles around this cliff. And besides, you promised me the extension.
I know. It's the bank. They threatened to call in my mortgage if I gave you the extension.
But, Colonel, that
You see, the bank has a new owner.
Brennan?
Yes. I'm sorry it ended like this, boys. I wanted to see you win. But I guess it just isn't in the cards. Sorry, boys.
That means I call the men off, don't it? No. Put them back to work. Make them work like devils.
Even devils couldn't lay that pipe to the refinery in less than a week.
You do as I tell you. That's what you're being paid for.
Trouble is, we ain't being paid, Peter. These men have been paid nothing for the past 2 weeks. They've been working because they've been promised pay when the pipe started to earn money. It ain't gonna earn money now. I guess we all know that.
It's no use, Peter. There's nothing more we can do.
Boys, I'm going back to work. Who's with me? All right, we're all licked. Let's crawl home like a pack of lick cur dogs. There ain't going to be any pipeline. Just a lot of iron rusting and rotting in the earth. It's too bad we don't lie down ourselves and rot. We ain't men, we ain't nothing.
What was I trying to do anyway? Who did I think I was? Who cares?
Peter! Peter!
Sally, how did you get here?
I came down for Mary. I came to warn you. They're going to hold you to your time limit.
Yes, I know. Look.
Your men quitting?
That's where we're all quitting.
Not you, Peter. You don't know what it is to quit.
I'm beginning to learn.
But the pipeline. You've given up everything for
That's
it.
Why I made a fool of myself. You knew I was a fool, too.
Oh, no, Peter.
You showed me what you thought of me and my notions, didn't you? And you were right, too.
No, Peter, I was wrong. Anybody's wrong who runs away from things. I can't bear to think of you running away. I'd expect you to fight until you dropped, until you didn't have enough strength in your body to move, not to turn tail and run home. Lick, that ain't like you, Peter.
Well, what do you want me to do?
What have you got to do?
There's 3 miles around that cliff to the refinery. It'd be a miracle to lay that much pipe in less than a week. They tell me I gotta do it in a day. I can't do it, you understand? Nobody can do it. I can't make the pipes fly over that cliff or climb over. I can't... Climb over. The rock would hold. We could pump it up.
You thought of something?
Can't talk to you now, Sally. Hey, Phil! Phil! Get out a spanking hammer. We are hanging the pipe to the bluff. Hang it straight over the hill. It's worth the try, boys. Come on!
Peter, I'm going with you.
No, no, Sally, you stay here. I can't take you. Come on, John! Come on, boys! We can rig up a block and tackle and pull the men up so they can drive in these spikes and run the pipes clear up to the top.
That's a pretty high cliff to climb.
I know that, but we can make it. Only we need more men.
We do that. And where are we going to get them?
How many more men do you need, Peter?
At least as many more as we have now.
I know. I know where I could get them.
Well, where, Sally?
Never mind. You put your men to work. I'll get you some help.
All right, boys, let's get started.
All right, come on, boys!
Bring your equipment over. All your spikes. Bring him down. Hey,
Where's Mr. Brennan?
What is it, Scanlon?
Cortland's up to something we ain't counted on.
I thought we'd counted on everything.
Not this. No, just by Adam's Bluff. You know down there by the pass?
Yes.
They're pushing the pipe right up over it.
Over the top?
Yeah.
Red, we've got to stop that. You better get your men together.
All right. You better come too, Mr. Brennan.
All right.
Hey, Jack, Jerry, get in here.
Where are you going, Red?
Adam's Bluff. Cortland again.
another great fight, but we still got work to do. We gotta finish that pipeline. Come on!
The time's nearly up.
Well, it isn't 12 o'clock yet.
Now, you see, the pipe here isn't what he's after. He's got to have oil in this tank. You can't make it, Cortland. You've only got 2 minutes. Start your pumps.
Start the pump! Start the pump! Start the pump!
He can't make it. You see? Your pipe doesn't help you. Gotta be oil.